Hey guys, so earlier this summer I read Fahrenheit 451 by Ray Bradbury, and it was really amazing and thought-provoking. You can see how many notes I made while reading it, and I'm still thinking about it now, weeks later, so I thought I would make a video on it. This book was chosen for the Nerdfighter Book Club, so you should check out John and Hank Green's videos, as well as some of the video responses. So far they've only covered part one, so I'll stick mainly to part one as well. I'll try not to give too many plot spoilers. I won't do a plot summary, so you should all read it if you haven't. It's pretty short, and it's definitely worth it. There are so many different things I could talk about, which is why I really like the book. Bradbury was a genius, in my opinion. The dystopian world Bradbury creates seems scarily believable at times, and possible of being realized in the not-too-distant future. But I think that although his warning is still applicable 60 years after he wrote it, we're not in any immediate danger of turning into this dystopia. The first aspect I think Bradbury wants to warn us about is technology. In the book, technology has basically replaced human interaction and made people cold and impersonal. I don't find this very convincing in our world. People still crave human connection. We're still involved with our families, schools, communities. In many cases, technology facilitates human connection. YouTube, for example, has led to the Nerdfighter community and this project that has let us stay in touch. The involvement around YouTube is based on the people that use it, not the website itself, and I think that applies to many other technologies as well. I think the Hound and its reaction to Montag can be read as a symbol of how technology literally turns on its creators. Spoiler alert, there's also some foreshadowing going on. However, like most technology today, it still needs instructions from humans. So technology itself isn't the problem, but rather our intent when using it. This could also be applied to a discussion of drones and other dehumanized warfare, but that's a huge topic by itself. Another possible objection to technology is that it makes life too easy. There's a quote on page 31 of my edition where Clarice says, "We never ask questions, or at least most don't. They just run the answers at you, bing, 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 and us sitting there." First of all, it's ironic that there's a search engine named Bing that prides itself on finding all the answers instantaneously. But I don't think that easy access to information is making us less curious or less intelligent. I think it lets us explore the harder, deeper questions because we no longer have to worry about memorizing facts that we can just look up. Ideally, we should be able to focus more on the bigger picture. The second part of Bradbury's vision is society itself. In this world, people only want pleasure and stability, and they've given up everything else. This part I find scarier and more prescient. It seems like people are becoming more and more passive, consuming more and caring less about the world around them. However, I don't think it's happening to the extent that it does in Fahrenheit 451. The first reason is that people still pay attention to current affairs and are affected by events that don't happen in their immediate vicinity. Unlike the characters in the book who see scores of jet planes flying overhead but don't know why or where the war is, we still hold our government accountable and have accurate sources of information that report on it. Although there are people who don't care what's going on or who accept what Fox News tells them unquestioningly, there are lots who are passionate and well-informed. Second, Bradbury predicts that education will become less and less important and that intellectual will become a curse word. I think that education is still valued very highly. The amount of college education required to get a good job is increasing, and so is the rate of college graduation. Although there are people who see intellectualism as snobby or elitist, I don't think we're at much risk. Third, Bradbury complains that minority interests and being politically correct will lead to censorship. He expresses this through Beatty when he talks about dumbing down of media, and he also talks about it directly in the afterword. I honestly don't see this happening at all. Looking at media in general, there are many more instances of offensive and crude things becoming popular, i.e. reality television, than of artistic works being shunned because they offend someone. Authors and artists still have complete autonomy over their aesthetic and over how politically correct they want to be. So while I think that we may be moving in the direction of a Fahrenheit-like world, there definitely isn't immediate danger of it being realized. I have to agree with Hank in that Mildred, Montag's wife, is not a very believable character at all. I don't think it's possible for someone to be that shut down emotionally and intellectually. I agree that people are not drones, and they never will be. In terms of awareness about society's function and curiosity about the outside world, I think most of us today are like Guy Montag. While Montag plays into society's self-perpetuated censorship, lighting fires and enjoying the pleasure of burning, he obviously senses subconsciously that something is wrong. He has some suppressed desire to question and escape the system. After all, he's been stealing books for about a year now. Clarice just enables him to step back and see what his actions actually mean. John asked what makes us feel most alive and when we feel least like we're wasting our time. I feel most alive when I'm making connections, both with other people and connections between ideas and concepts in my own brain. I love debating with people and learning from them and possibly teaching them something. I love doing puzzles like a curl that require logic. I love reading about science and watching videos and getting that feeling when things start to come together and click in your brain. Someday, I hope to discover new things and connect new pieces of knowledge to our current understanding. I think it's important and really invigorating to be aware of the world outside ourselves. After all, society is defined by what individual people do. That means that we have the power and the responsibility to change society because we are society. All we can do is make educated decisions and continue to be alive and hope that maybe we will be a Clarice to someone's Montag. There's lots more I could say about the book, so maybe I'll do another video on parts 2 and 3 when the Vlogbrothers have posted their videos. Stay magical and DFTBA.